last, the very last people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will then say to them, Udkhulul Jannah, go ahead and enter Jannah. And we even have a beautiful hadith about the very last person to enter Jannah completely. The very last person to enter Jannah completely. And this is a hadith reported in Sahih Muslim by the famous companion Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu an, that he said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the very last person to enter Jannah will be a person who is walking with difficulty, you know, towards the exit, away from Jahannam. And he slips sometimes, and he falls sometimes, and he stands up, and he continues walking. And the fire continues to just come. The fire or the flame comes and, you know, hurts him and takes it back until finally when he exits. And so he has been told he can leave, right? And so he is basically the very last person. Now he is walking out of that area of punishment. And it's not an easy walk after all that long time that he has now finally, you know, able to walk, but not without any problems till the very end, until finally when he exits that area, he shall turn around and he shall say, Tabaraka alladhi najani minka. All glory be to Allah who saved me from you. Indeed, Allah has given me a blessing that no other person has ever been given. Meaning, what is the blessing? I am the last person. That's it. Everybody who has left is now khalas, permanent and forever. So this is the person he recognizes, that he is the very last person to exit from Jahannam. And then, so he's just exited, right? And of course, while he was in Jahannam, his only dua was, Oh Allah, let me out. Oh Allah, let me out. Oh Allah, just get me out of here. Now that dua is answered. He is the last person. So now that dua has been answered. He is now outside. And then when he gets outside, then he sees in the distance a tree. He sees in the distance a tree. And so he makes another dua to Allah. And he says, Oh Allah, allow me to just get to that tree so that I can sit down and take shade under its shade and drink from the water around that tree. And so again, so he has the first dua was, let me out of Jahannam. He's out of Jahannam. Now he sees a tree in that area outside of Jannah, right? It's the area that's leading to Jannah, but it's still a far place away. But all right now he can see that one tree. So he says, Oh Allah, allow me to go there. So Allah Azza wa Jal says, well, if I give you this, what if you ask me for more after this? The man will say, I promise you, Oh Allah, I promise you that that's the only thing I want. And the Prophet ﷺ remarked, and Allah has already excused him for breaking that promise. He's going to break it. Allah knows. And Allah has excused him because Allah knows that the man has no patience. We are like this. خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. We don't have that patience. Never ever say to Allah, never say to Allah that, Oh Allah, I'm never going to ask you anything more. Because we need Allah for every single millisecond. We will never be sufficient from Allah. We always need Allah. And in our need to Allah is our izzah. In our poverty to Allah is our richness. Never say, Oh Allah, that's the only thing I want. No, Oh Allah, I want more from you and more and more. And I want everything you will give me. Because, Oh Allah, I am faqir and you are the ghani. But this man doesn't know all of this. This man is the last person exiting Jahannam. This man is not paying attention to hadith and knowing all of this knowledge. Whatever he has done in his life, you know, khalas, that is the very last person to exit Jahannam. And so he will say to Allah, Oh Allah, I promise you that is the last thing I will ever ask. And so Allah gives him permission. So now he has the power to walk to this tree, and then he will sit down and he will enjoy this tree, and he will drink and he will stay in the shade. But then now he is enjoying, he's looking around and he sees a tree more beautiful than this one, bigger than this one. And he'll remain quiet because he'll remember his promise. He'll remain quiet. But for how long? How many decades? How many millennia is he going to remain quiet? And so he then says that, Ya Rabb, O my Lord, I ask you that let me go to that tree over there. Allah will say, O son of Adam, didn't you promise me that if I let you in this tree, you would not ask anything else? And so the man will say, Ya Rabb, let me just give to that one tree and then I promise you nothing more. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, okay. And the Prophet ﷺ said once again that Allah has excused him because Allah knows he doesn't have the patience to remain quiet. So he will then go to that tree, and he will live under that tree and drink from its and eat from its fruits and drink from its water. But then he will see a tree that is outside of the peripheries of the gates of Jannah. He'll see a tree, and he knows after that tree is Jannah. And so that tree is even more beautiful than this one. And Allah knows, in some versions, by the way, there are 10 trees. In some versions, you know, 3 trees. But the point is, keep on, until finally he comes to the largest and the most beautiful tree. And that tree is within visual distance of the gates of Jannah. And each time he's promising Allah nothing more, until finally he gets to that tree, and he can now hear the laughter of the people of Jannah, the murmuring of the waters of Jannah. He can smell the fragrance of Jannah. How long do you think he is going to remain there? How long is he going to remain there? After he has made a solemn oath, and another solemn, and another solemn oath, and maybe 10 oaths to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and each time he promises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that nothing more, but now he is literally at the gates of Jannah. Literally, this is the last person to enter Jannah. And so he raises his hands and he says, "Ey Rabbi, adkhilniha. Oh my Rabb, allow me to just enter Jannah. Just enter Jannah. Adkhilniha." And so Allah Azza wa Jal will say, "O son of Adam, what will cause you to stop all of this asking? What will it be enough of you? Will you be happy if I give you the entire dunya and all that is like it? Will you be happy that this whole world of blessings, the whole dunya, imagine, and another one like it, will you be happy?" And at this, the man becomes irritated and he says, "Oh my Lord, are you making fun of me? And you are the Rabbul Alameen? Are you joking? You're joking, oh Allah, and you are Allah Azza wa Jal, and you're making fun of me that you're going to say you give me this whole dunya?" And then Ibn Mas'ud, who was narrating the hadith, he began to laugh. And he said to his students, "Do you know why I'm laughing?" They said, "Why?" He said, "Because when our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned this hadith, he too laughed. And then he asked us, 'Do you know why I'm laughing?' And then they said, 'Why?' The Prophet said, 'Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will laugh at the impatience of this man and this frustration of the man when the man says, are you making fun of me? Are you joking? And you are the Lord of the worlds?' And then Allah will respond, 'I am not making fun of you. I am not joking. I am capable of doing anything that I please. You shall have this world and 10 times like it.'" And that will be the last person to enter Jannah. Think about that, dear Muslims. This is our final hadith for today. Think about that. We want this dunya, 1/100 millionth of it. That's it, and we're going to be happy. If we have the smallest portion, the richest people earn and own how much? A few billion dollars. And look at their lifestyles. Can you imagine this whole world, the whole dunya, and all of the pleasures of this dunya? And 10 times, I mean, our mind just goes blank. Our mind goes blank. And Allah says to this last person to enter Jannah, that is all yours. What then do you think of those higher up? What do you think of Firdaus? Because you see, this guy, he got the dunya. And we understand the dunya. We see the dunya. We know the pleasures of the dunya, and it's great. But the people above him, in the highest places, فيها ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. In that place, words cease to have meaning. There are no words to describe those levels of Jannah. So this guy got the dunya, and we know the dunya. But the people of the highest levels, they shall get that which the eyes have not even seen, and the ears have not even heard descriptions of, nay, even the minds and the hearts have even conceived. Some of us, when we hear this hadith, they say, "I'll be happy if I'm that last person." And I say, "Why? Why? Why aim for that? Aim for the highest of the high. Aim for Firdaus al-A'la. And then inshaAllah ta'ala, work for it. And maybe, just maybe, if you don't get to the very highest, at least you'll get to a much, much higher place. Don't aim low, aim high, and make dua to Allah that Allah Azza wa Jal makes us from the Firdaus al-A'la. InshaAllah ta'ala, until next time, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh."